Hey, what's up, everybody? Today's project is going to be making a lawn striper for the back of my riding mower. So the basic idea is, I'm going to take this PVC pipe, and I have these end caps. I'll run this bar, threaded bar, through it, which will stick out of the cap. And I'll drill a hole in the cap. That'll stick out of the cap, and then I'll put an eye bolt on there, and then I'll have an eye bolt sticking up this way. And then I'm gonna use these pieces here, cut those, cut that. The idea is gonna be to come back down and out, and then see if I can make some sort of brace. I don't really know what it's gonna look like, and it may not work, but. Here we go. Okay, so the first thing I did is I put both caps on and measured, and you can kind of see how it's curved out, measured the total length. First I measured the black bar. I'm like, okay, I need 57 inches. 57 inches inside that threaded part. So I put both these caps on, put the tape on the ground so I could see exactly how long it was. Turns out it's 64 inches on the PVC. So I need to take 7 inches off the total length. So I'll mark 7, take that off. I want to put the caps back on. It should be 57. All right, so update time. I got the back roller built. And basically what I did is I marked and cut it off, like I said. Drilled the holes through. I just used a 7/8 inch spade. So punch the hole, put this bar through, stuck the eye bolt on, and capped it off. So when I got the one side on, I went down to the, I had some crusher run. I just stood it up and just stacked it full of crusher run. So it's pretty heavy. Now we'll see if this bracket, effectively I want to get it to where, I have the bagger set up so I can have it hang back a little bit. I don't want it too steep, because then it'll tend to want to try to climb back under the wheels. So I got to try to find, that sweet spot without it being too far back. Obviously the flatter the better, but. Anyways, we'll see what I come up with. All right, so this is how it came out and what I came up with. So, as before, I came up. It's not really angle iron, but whatever you want to call it. Right, I used, we'll see. It might pop off of here. It's an existing spot in there. It has the chance to pop up and out of there, but it's pretty tight. We'll see how it goes. Hopefully it just rolls. I did, when I first started, I just had this L on here, and it was pretty floppy. So then I added this crossbar. I did buy a flat piece just because I knew I was probably going to have to brace it up. So I added that, and then it was still slopping in these corners here. So I just added some corner braces there. So, it's pretty sturdy, but it's also pretty heavy. So I don't know how it's gonna go. It's pretty wide, a lot wider than any of the videos I've seen. So hopefully it lays down some wide stripes. We'll see. If you go, effectively where it's gonna lay down is here, and it's just outside of 54 inches, and it's a 54 inch deck. So I gotta edge and trim this, trim around and before I mow, so it'll be a little bit, but I'll try to get a picture of what it looks like afterwards. I'm racing against the sun, so anyway, stay tuned. All right, so I just got in. It's dark. I had to use the headlights, but it worked. Didn't fall apart, didn't break. I will say that I think you need to build, if you're gonna build the bracket system, you need to have some sort of flexibility in there, because if you make it too rigid, you're asking for it to break. There's a couple times when I was driving up alongside the fence and it would just roll right over it, or it would flex a little bit and it would end up giving and going. So, you want to make it sturdy, but you also want to have it be able to flex, flex for you. So there's probably better ideas, better designs, but that's what I came up with. It's still attached on the back of my tractor, so for me, it's a win. And you can decide for yourself with stripes. It got dark, and my lawn's not in the best shape. They just put another set of fertilizer on, so hopefully it greens up and gets rid of some of those brown spots. But in general, I'm happy. So let me know your thoughts in the comments. Thanks.